Hello everybody, welcome to the Python math section. In this video, I'm going to do the rotation of a list from the right-hand side or from the left-hand side. So whether or not you do the rotation on either side, you still have to determine the net number of steps to shift, and I will explain it to you later. We also have to understand whether we are doing the left shift or the right shift. And after that, we have to do the appropriate popping at the insertion of the elements to complete the rotation. Now, let us see an example of the shift from the right-hand side by 8 steps. Now, I have a list of 5 elements. Since the list length, which is 5, is smaller than the step number, which is 8, we can expect that some shifts are redundant. So we can say that the net shift to the right-hand side can be equal to the remainder when we divide 8 by 5. So the remainder is simply equal to 3. In essence, we just need to shift the elements by 3 times. Now, let us see the first step out of the 3 steps involved. So the first step involves popping the last element from the list. So now element number 5 is removed from the list. Then I'm going to put the popped element to the front of the list. So now I'm going to move element number 5 to the front. After the movement of element number 5 to the first position, we can see that we have 5, 1, 2, 3, 4 being the ordered elements. So after step 1 out of 3, the list has completed one shift from the right. Now let us see the second step out of the 3 steps involved. Now we pop the last element, which is 4. And then I want to put the popped element, which is 4, to the front of the list. Now after the movement, we can see that in this step, which is the second step, the list has completed one more shift from the right-hand side. So now we have the elements as 4, 5, 1, 2, and 3. Now we do the final step of the 3 steps. Now we pop the last element, which is 3. And then we put the popped element to the front of the list. After the movement, we can see that we have 3, 4, 5, 1, and 2 being the ordered elements. And after the final step, which is step number 3, the list has completed one more shift from the right-hand side. And now we see that the shifting is complete, so the numbers will remain in this order after the shifting process is completed. Now, let us see another example of the shifting from the left-hand side by 2 steps. Now, the list length, which is 5, is larger than the step number, which is only 2. So, actually, we have no redundant shifts. Now, when we do the left shifting, we have to pop the first element out of the list. And then we want to put the popped element to the end of the list. And after the first step out of the 2 steps, the list completes one shift from the left, and the elements will be in this order, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 1 finally. Okay, we are going to do the second step, which is the last step of the shifting from the left-hand side. Now we pop the first element, which is 2. And then we just put the popped element to the end of the list. Now after the second step out of the 2 steps, the list has completed one more shift from the left hand side. And now in this case, the shifting is complete. So finally we have 3, 4, 5, 1, and 2 as the order of the elements inside the list. Now let us see the implementation. I would like to set up a function to do the rotation of a list. So let me try to start the setup of the function. Now I have to put a list inside the function, and I want to do the shifting. So I have to put the number of shifts required to do the shifting. And in this definition of the shift, I have something to talk about it. If the shift number is a positive number, it means that I'm going to do the shifting from the right-hand side. Okay, if the shift number is negative, I would simply do the shifting from the left-hand side of the list, okay? So we know that it is possible to have some redundant shift when the shift number is actually larger than the length of the list. So how can we simply find the net shift? We can have a deficient in this way. Okay, we can simply do the deficient to find out the remainder. Okay, we can simply do the deficient of the shift by the length of a list. Here, the shift has to take the absolute value instead of taking the shift value alone, because it is possible that the shift value is a negative number, as shown here. When we have turned the shift number to be an absolute number, we can simply find out the net shift required to do the rotation correctly. And we simply find out the remainder when we divide the absolute value of the shift by the length of a list, okay? And then we can simply do the shifting after getting the net shift number. Now we just have to take a look at the number of shifts required. If the shift is larger than 0, it means that I'm going to do the shift from the right-hand side. Here, I want to find out the element to be popped, which is simply the last element inside the list. Since we want to find out the last element, we have to make use of the length, and then we have to subtract 1 from the length. Otherwise, we are not able to find out the index of the final element. Okay, here I just want to insert the popped element to the very first position of the list. So I have to set up the position to be 0. So I just want to insert the element to become the first element of the list. So how about the shift from the left hand side? We can do something like this. Okay, if the shift from the left is needed, I just want to pop the far left element, which is having an index of 0. After that, I simply append the element to the far end of the list. Here, I just want to put the element to the far right-hand side of the list. Or we just say that we want to put it to the last element. Okay, the function is complete. And we can have one more point to discuss. Here we have considered the shift which is positive and which is negative. How about when the shift is 0? When the shift is 0, it also implies that the left shift is also 0. It means that the for loop is never entered when the shift is really 0. Okay, it just means that the for loop will end immediately. We don't ever need to enter the for loop when the left shift is simply equal to 0, which also implies that the shift is actually a multiple of the length of the list. Okay, now let us try the function. Suppose I have a list of 8 elements, 1 to 8. Now I want to do the rotation by 3 elements to the right hand side. What do we expect? Okay, we will see that we have 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. It just means that I simply do the shifting from the left hand side. So the first step is to put 8 before 1, and then I do the second rotation to put 7 before 8. Finally, I put 6 before 7. So I will have this list coming out. So how about the case when I just want to do the shifting from the left by 4 elements, starting with this list content? Let me see the effect. Okay, suppose we are given this list as the beginning of the rotate list function. When I want to do the shifting by 4 elements from the left, the first step is simply to put 6 next to 5, and then I put 7 next to 6, and then I put 8 next to 7. Finally, I would put 1 next to 8. So that's why I have the value coming out in this way. So when we compare the result here from the result there, we have simply done the shifting of 4 times from the left hand side. Okay, 6, 7, 8, 1 are put next to the value of 5. Okay, so in this video, we have already discussed a way to do the rotation of a list from the basic principle. So we have to understand that the shift can be positive or negative, meaning that the shift direction can be left or right. And then we can just simply find out the net shift required. And then we simply depend on the sign of the shift to do the appropriate popping and insertion. This is the end of the video. If you have any questions about my video, please leave your questions on the comment section below the video. If you like this video, please give me a like and please subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching.